all the way to England to find one, but we got it.
That's awesome. Sweet.
I'm going home to Nome, Alaska, baby, don't you want to go? They got gobs and gobs and piles of snow, and the seals are baying low. I'm getting out of New York City, shoveling a pile for me. I've been gone and gone, out in the city, Alaska is the place to be. Ba-da-ba, bum-ba-boom, yeah, yeah.
And I think it says Great Britain and Ireland.
Whoa, look at that. It says
Denby Pottery
near Derby.
Derby.
Patent. Is it cracked on the bottom? Oh, still want to take it. That's really cool.
That is cool.
Very awesome. Look at that. It's a slick. Doesn't look like there's any words. I don't know. I'll have to go ask him. Still really, really cool.
When, you know, when they're about to be fired, they throw salt in the kiln. So that's why sometimes you get like a pattern. Sometimes it'll be not, you know, not quite light in colour. Another side it'll be quite brown because they sort of throw the salt in, and it hasn't got to the other side. So the salt kind of reacts in the atmosphere of the kiln.
Interesting.
To give that sort of browny, glazed colour.
Interesting.
Looks like a small cod bottle. Yeah, the top is, it's a small cod bottle. The top is broken off. You can see the shape.
Oh, he's gonna pinch you. You better be careful.
I was like, what is green in there? I thought it was that
ancient pottery.
Oh, it feels like it's embossed on the other side. Let's see if it's whole. Nope, top's broken. But it's got words on it. I can cut the top off. It says IDRIS. Idris. Ooh, down there a ways.
Yeah.
I'm hoping maybe it's cold. It feels like it's down in there really good, so maybe it is whole. Let's see. Oh, I found a whole little pot. See if there's words on it yet. I'm gonna clean it up, I guess, but it's whole. It's pottery. Very cool.
It looks like there's another whole one right next to it, but a small one.
There's a little small one that was right next to the other one.
Excellent.
Two whole little pots dug side by side. Beautiful.
The wind is so bad here, you couldn't hear me. But what I was saying is we are having a great time in spite of the storm.
I know, I'm in a really good spot too. I just dug out two pots.
Clayton. BRDS. Give him a go. That would have been so beautiful. Check that out.
Part of it is broken, but it has a beautiful little handle on it. Look at that pot. Oh, can't get the mud out of it, but look at that. It probably would have had a poor spout. This one's nice. It's complete.
Oh, that's one, yeah. That's an ink bottle, that one. Completely seaweed.
Yeah. Get the seaweed off of it. Wow, a little ink.
1900, thereabouts.
Look at that one.
Oh. Almost. It's been a fire by the looks of things, but it's slightly warped at the end. But yeah, this is a complete torpedo. Oh, quite cautious, but it's a company.
It is a little melted. That's not bad though. It'll kind of clean up even though the top's not there. Looks like the storm's blowing in. It's okay. The most damaged, rough glass stopper, but super cool. Windy and rainy. Check it out. Rough shape. Now look what I found. Looks like a very unhappy baby head. I think maybe I need to rescue it. This little jar. Beautiful little jar. Super cool. Socked in pretty good today now, and raining, so I'm not doing a lot of videoing, but still out here finding some cool pieces. Then I saw this sticky wheel right here, and there's a little top. It's not embossed, but it's a cool little cork top. Says California Fig Syrup Company over here in England. Yeah.
He does this once a day for about 3 hours every day of the year. You found some good stuff?
Yeah, I got a couple.
Nice one.
The ones embossed. I think it says California, so we came all the way to England to get a California bottle.
Probably a fig syrup. I'm not sure what fig syrup is. Maybe a sweetener or something.
Yeah.
We'll take a break and go in the woods and see what we can find there.
Okay, sounds good.
Got a little twist in the neck from the... There's some kind of embossed. Oh, it's that Eiffel Tower.
London, SE.
Yeah, that's southeast.
London, southeast. S. Dodman.
Yeah. Don't know who he is, but he's a sauce bottle. So that's had some kind of sauce in it.
Bottom of one.
That would be a fun one to look up. Whoa, look at that beautiful piece of art. Oh, really pretty
part of a blue plate. Just gorgeous. Yeah, see, like dinner plate? Huge cork top bottle.
Really?
Yeah, and it's whole.
Nuh-uh.
Look.
No way.
It's a big amber cork top bottle. It's massive. It's not embossed, but it's a cork top and it's huge.
I think I have one of the coolest bottles ever.
Okay.
And it's old.
Dang.
And it has words.
Oh my gosh, it's beautiful.
RW and SL white.
It is. It's one of those whole white bottles. We saw parts of them out there.
No way. Always wanted to find one of these. These are the mineral water bottles, I believe. I had to come all the way to England to find one, but we got it.
That's awesome.
Sweet.
Little ink bottle just came popping out of here. This is amazing. This is awesome. What just fell out of the hole here? Look at that. Warner. South Road, Southeast.
Yeah, you have like a
WC and Company.
Supply, huh? Right here.
Teaspoons. Little medicine.
Whoa. Look at that design. Trademark on the bottom.
My phone is just covered in mud. Little tiny one just fell out right here. Oh, babe, it's a glass ink with a cork top.
No way.
Yeah, and it's green.
Yeah.
And there's a symbol on the bottom, too. Oh, look at that. Beautiful little one.
It says not to be taken. Green poison.
Dang.
Cork top.
Nice.
Now you got to leave that behind.
Very cool. It's poison. I can't take it.
No. Can't take it.
First poison bottle ever.
Oh really?
Yep.
That's
a really
good one.
So,
not embossed,
like
but it's gorgeous.
Right, and everything different. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And just buy
quite
expensive.
This, because they're
expensive. Okay.
Quite expensive, I mean like 20 or 30 pounds. Because you think of what you pay for it.
Oh, another part of the torpedo.
Oh, what?
Embrocation for horses. London.
Trying to do a cleanup on some of the stuff that we got, and Jeremy went to rinse a bottle out, and we found that we have a little friend.
Herbert,
the little crab. Decided he was going to come home with us for a little bit, so we're going to put him in the cup and then we're going to take him back out once we're done here and put him out where he will be happy.